Hey guys, how's it going? BCHD here. Welcome back to the season finale of the Padma Road to Glory career mode on FIFA 19. Thank you guys for all the support you've showed on the series so far. But this will be the final episode of season number one. So get your transfer request in down below just in time for season number two. But we're getting this one kicked off. Sit back, relax. We've got an action-packed episode awaiting you guys to end off season number one. And for the last month, we got Tonali, Sancho, and Inglese nominated for the Player of the Month. But it's going to be a big episode, guys. Are we going to finish in the Europa League spots in either 5th or 6th? Or will we drop off into mid-table? What's going to happen, guys? We are going to get straight into it with this game against Frosinone away from home. We're going to simulate it. And we got off to a good start with Inglese. Frosinone getting the equaliser, but Cicciretti getting one right before halftime to make it 2-1 as we continue on simulating. Dybala getting two goals for Frosinone as Jadon Sancho in the 82nd minute gets us a winner at the Stadio Benito Stirpe in Frosinone, and we end up getting the 3-2 victory there. So we're starting off the season finale with a simulated victory against Frosinone, and that's just going to push us further up the table as we need wins to just get this Europa League spot. And Jadon Sancho, our January summer signing, we swapped him for Jovinho with Borussia Dortmund. He gets the March Player of the Month, and well-deserved from him, as he's been playing really, really well for us. It took him a bit of time, maybe in January, February, just to gel with the team. And, you know, I had to get used to playing with him. But we are getting straight into our next game against Torino at home at the Stadio Ennio Tardini. And, yeah, we desperately need 3 points in this one. A bit of a rotated lineup, as you guys can see. And we're getting straight into it. Europa League qualification is on the line in all these games. We're getting through the last 2 months of April and May. As you can see, the table right there. Lazio right above us. And Roma is just under us, just on our tails at the moment, so we can't afford to drop any points in the season as we get this game started off against Torino. We are on the attack. It's Roche on the end of it. David gives the ball off to Taith Chong, and he slots it into the top left-hand corner, and the Dutchman gets his first goal for Parma, and it's come against Torino at home, and what a strike it was. Grassi gave it to David. David laid it off to Chong, and he struck it from outside the box, put it in the top left corner. Senegal could not do anything about that one, and we get the 1-0 advantage here against Torino at home. Just a perfect start we needed, as Torino are looking to get the equaliser here. Paulsen puts the ball through to Iago Falke. Iago Falke hits the post. Sepe came out for that one, but unfortunately for them, didn't pay off for them as we Torino continue on the attack. They're trying to get the equaliser as we go into the second half. It's Simone Zaza. I bring out Sepe. Sepe slides. Padu. I don't even know what's going on here. What a piece of play that was. I mean, I'm trying to switch to go to Mai to clear it, and it's not letting me switch from Impadu to Mai. And then when it does, the ball's right in front of Simone Zaza, and it would have been a goal. It just would have. I had to slide tackle, and thankfully it wasn't a red card, but Zaza will be taking the penalty. The man that missed it for Italy in Euro 2016 does exactly the same in Parma right now. And Sepe makes another penalty save. He's made a few this season. And we continue on as Torino get a last-minute free kick. We're still 1-0 up in this one. And we commit a foul here right at the end. 2 minutes of added time. This will be the last kick of the game. Can we hold on for the 3 points? We are going to see, and we do eventually hold on for the 3 points. It's all 3 points at home against Torino. Taith Chong with the goal, and he gets us the 1-0 lead, enough to get the 3 points against Torino. So the first two games of this episode, we've gotten a win. Good for us, but we're on to the next game as we're taking on Sassuolo. And as you can see here, a little match preview from Serie A, as this is a regional derby, and it's not only a regional derby, the Emilia-Romagna derby, it is also a battle for the Europa League positions, as Sassuolo are another team on our tails. And we're, yeah, it's going to be a regional derby, and it's going to be a Europa League. It's going to decide who's going to get the Europa League next season. We're away at Sassuolo at the Mapei Stadium in Sassuolo, and we are going into this one with that away kit, the yellow and blue stripes. And it's going to be a big, big match for us. A crucial match. Every game in this episode is pretty much a crucial match in the season finale, guys. As you can see there, they're 6 points away from us. So we're going to be careful here, as Roma are just 1 point away. But Sassuolo are on the attack here. Duncan puts the ball through. Di Francesco goes through and he hits the crossbar. What a strike. And it's Kevin Prince-Boateng slotting it home. But unfortunately for Sassuolo, he is offside. Their new summer signing thought he bagged himself a goal in the regional derby, but as you can see there, he was offside from Di Francesco, shot off the crossbar, and we're on the attack. Tonali puts the ball through to Alessandro Mergia, and he gets the first goal in this match against Sassuolo, and what a finish from the central midfielder we picked up from Lazio this summer. Cicciretti found Tonali. Tonali slotted it through the chamber. And we get Mergia a goal here. And what a finish. It was like a finesse shot slash chip over Consigli. And wow, what a piece of play that was. Cicciretti, a goal made in Italy that was. Cicciretti through to Tonali, through to Mergia. And we get a perfect 1-0 lead here as Jadon Sancho, the March player of the month, makes his way through. And unfortunately, with the finesse shot, couldn't slot it home. Going to back up his good form and couldn't get a goal there. But Sassuolo on the attack here. Sepe makes a lovely save and it falls straight to the path of Di Francesco for Sassuolo. Getting the equalizer here away from home, at home for Sassuolo. But unfortunately, we couldn't hold on until halftime with that 1-0 lead through Mergia. And Di Francesco gets the goal. Sepe made a lovely save, but it fell straight into the path of the Sassuolo attacker. And we concede the equaliser right before halftime, which is pretty disappointing. But Sassuolo were through on goal there in the 73rd minute. We make a few substitutions, and it's looking towards the end of the game here as the 78th minute comes. And Inglese puts the ball through to Jonathan Biabiani for the winner. And Consigli makes a beautiful save there. Unfortunately, we couldn't get the goal to make it 2-1. And Sassuolo on the attack here. Berardi on this right-hand side. Pellegrini can't keep up with him whatsoever. Berardi is fought off. He crosses the ball in. And it's Babacar in the 84th minute, getting a goal for Sassuolo, making it 2-1 in front of their home fans. Berardi down that right-hand side, and it was a perfect cross through to Babacar, and he headed that one home, and we look dead and buried at the moment. We concede a last-minute loss to Sassuolo, and it's a 2-1. I mean, that was hard. That's a harsh game that we just had. We get our first loss of the episode. Hopefully, that won't affect us for Europa League qualification, but we are up against AC Milan. It doesn't get any tougher than this. We had a few easy games to start off the episode, but now we are back home at the Stadio Ennio Tardini against fifth place AC Milan right above us. Literally, it's a Europa League battle. It was a big game in general. It doesn't matter where we were. It was always going to be a big game against AC Milan. But, I mean, this has just got so much on the line at the moment. We need a win, and we don't get off to the start we wanted as Giacomo Bonaventura gets a shot off outside the box and converts it. And we go 1-0 down in the 11th minute. Europa League battle as well. They're right above us in terms of points. And unfortunately, we concede there, and the AC Milan travelling fans are enjoying it so far, as Higuain put the ball through to Bonaventura. He had a shot from outside the box, and Sepe couldn't do much about that. It's a bit of a rotated lineup as well, and Pardew getting a shot in there. And unfortunately, we go 1-0 down, but we're trying to find the equaliser here as David gets the ball through to Shaparenko. Grassi finds David. He's 1-on-1 with Donnarumma here. Donnarumma saves, but it falls right back to the Canadian. David getting the equaliser for us against AC Milan just 10 minutes later after they scored. And I decided to put him in instead of Roberto Inglese, because Inglese hasn't been scoring as of late. But David has stepped up to the plate. It was a lovely over-the-top ball from Grassi. Donnarumma with that save. And David got the rebound. We finally get a bit of rebound luck in this career mode and slotted it through two AC Milan defenders, and we get the equaliser here at home against some Europa League contenders as well, as we start off the second half here on the front foot as David tries to put the ball through, and we get the ball back just in this half. Desi finds Grassi. Grassi can find Jadon Sancho, our player of the month for March, gets the goal. The Englishman, he's been on form in real life, and he's showing some great form in our Parma career mode. Grassi with another assist. He found Jadon Sancho in a pocket of space and the little slot under the keeper. The finesse shot into that far hand corner. We get the 2-1 lead against AC Milan, and we are flying here at home against former European giants. They're fighting for Europa League position. We're fighting for Europa League position. Doesn't get any more exciting than this, but Gonzalo Higuain hits the post and could have got the equaliser straight off kickoff. We would have been celebrating a bit too early there, but in the 57th minute, hit the post as AC Milan are through here. Chanalogu somehow makes it through four of our defenders twice, slots it through to Higuain, and the Argentinian makes up for his shot off the post. And in the 63rd minute, AC Milan get the equaliser to make it 2-2. I don't know how Chanalogu somehow made it through three people twice, not once, but twice, and he finds Gonzalo Higuain, and he slots it past Sepe, and it was a great finish in the end. Left foot strike, and Sepe couldn't do much about that one. Gonzalo Higuain makes it 2-2. He's got a goal and assist to his name as we're trying to find the winner here in the 67th minute. David finds Desi, and Desi slots it home. He doesn't really score that much. He doesn't really start that much, but he started this match against AC Milan. The former Perugia man puts the ball in the top right-hand corner, and we make it 3-2 at home. It's goals galore at the moment as David finds Desi. Desi just thumped it into the top right hand corner. What a goal that was, and what a strike. I mean, not even a finesse shot, just straight up smashed it home, and Donnarumma just had to let it in. That was way too powerful for him to stop. And Desi, Jacopo Desi, one goal in Serie A team. It's his first goal, his first contribution for us, and it might have come at the most crucial time as Sepe makes a lovely save there as AC Milan do a few substitutions, and we're finding our way in the last few minutes here. 3 minutes of added time. I'm trying to waste a bit of time with Sepe here, trying to wind down the clock because we're in the driver's seat at the moment. We can't afford to lose this one, but Sprocati gets the ball, and that'll be the end of it. A 5-goal thriller at home, 3-2 to us, and what a game. What a win to get against Europa League opposition, AC Milan, and just a big, big home victory, a 3-2 nail-biter, a Jacopo Desi first goal of the season, and we absolutely loving it at the moment. A big, big win against AC Milan. Probably one of our wins of the season as we do a bit more player training here with David, Sancho, Tonali and Chong. And what a game that was. I still can't believe that to this day. We got a very, very good game there against AC Milan as we're still sitting in six. We're 3 points away from AC Milan in fifth place as we just beat them. We get 3 points closer to them, but we have a game against Chievo Verona away from home, and Jadon Sancho in the simulation gets the goal in the 14th minute to put us 1-0 up. We still got a second half to go, but Jadon Sancho still going strong, and he's got a second to his name. 50th minute, he adds a second goal. He's on a brace at the moment, and we're entering the last few minutes here as Nabokin gets a goal for Chievo, and that will be it. Jadon Sancho double gets us the win away from home in Verona. Nababkin couldn't do much about it in the 81st minute, and Chievo get the loss there. We get another win to our name, and Tonali goes up to a 75 rating in training as we continue on to the next game. This is our next month ahead in May. We've got Sampdoria, Bologna, and then our last two games of the season, it's Fiorentina and Roma to finish off the season. Those are going to be the last two crucial games. Roma is 1 point away from us. After all these wins we've gotten in the past few games, Roma is still just 1 point away from us. Like, imagine if we drop points in any of those games, We would not be sitting in a Europa League spot at the moment. We go into this one against Sampdoria at home, and Bastoni gets his first goal of the season to equalise against Praia's opener, and we are 1-1 with Sampdoria at the moment. Continuing on the simulation, we're at home at the Ennio Tardini. We should be getting, we should be picking up points here. Sancho gets a goal in the 82nd minute, and we get another 2-1 victory. Sancho is firing at the moment, and we are just getting a lot of clutch victories. 3-2s, 2-1s, 1-0s. We are getting them all in this episode. The season finale is just starting to heat up, and we're into the last few games of the season, and we're going to see what happens right here as we go into our next match against Bologna, currently sitting in 12th, so I think I went on and simulated this one. Roma, 4 points behind us, but we've played a game ahead of them, and we're going up against Bologna away from home. This is going to be a big, big one as Bologna and Chievo were in mid-table. Sanabria gets a goal for Bologna at home in the 14th minute. We go 1-0 down. Inglese gets injured, but Tonali gets us a goal. The equaliser in the 82nd, but Davin missed a penalty in the 66th minute. And it is the last episode of the season, meaning a lot of our loan players, such as Inglese, Cicciretti, Grassi, it's going to be their last episode, and they might not even play for us ever again, as Sancho moved up to a 78. But we have an important match against Fiorentina, as I would have thought. You know, you'd think of Fiorentina as a top 9, top 8, top 7 club, but we got our best team into this game. We look at the table, and Fiorentina are currently sitting in 13th, mid-table, a disappointing season, completely missed the mark, Fiorentina. We are down in 7th as Roma have played a few more games than us and gotten points, picked up points. So it's crucial for us to pick up points in this one against Fiorentina. I mean, if they were maybe in the top 7, I would have played it, but they're in 13th. I mean, they're not really having that great of a season. As we go into this simulation, Virtu gets a goal to make it 1-0, and we are currently down here at home. Bastoni gets his second goal in as many games, and we end up drawing that one. I know, if I played it, we probably could have won, but it's actually set up the best finale you guys are going to see, because in our last game against Roma at the Stadio Olimpico, it's basically whoever wins gets Europa League qualification for next season. So Grassi, Sancho and Inglese in that little cutscene, a win would see qualification for the Europa League. Roma and Parma in a key battle for European football next season. As you can see there, Serie A is hyping up this match, and it's probably our most important match of the season. After that draw against Fiorentina, it's set up probably our biggest game of the season. If we draw, we're not going to get Europa League qualification because of goal difference. But if we win, we are going to be playing in the Europa League next season alongside all those teams. As you can see there, our last look at the table for you guys before we head into this big match against Roma away from home at the Stadio Olimpico in Rome. It's pretty much a cup final for us. I mean, this is the closest thing we're going to get to a cup final. Our most important match of the season. It's Roma taking on Parma. It's a battle for Europa League football next season. And it was our goal at the start of this to get Parma back to European glory in this career mode. Back to the glory days of Parma. Hoping to get them back to where they once were and hopefully win some silverware this season or next season. But we're on the attack with Roberto Inglese. He takes a shot, it lands to Tonali, and we get the perfect start in the 6th minute here against Roma. Tonali has an absolute screamer from outside the box, and he's had a decent episode. He got an assist in the first few games, and he has topped it off with a goal here away at Roma at the Stadio Olimpico at the biggest of occasions. It's Tonali putting that one past the goalkeeper, and we go 1-0 up. And by the looks of things, if it stays this way, we're getting Europa League football. We cannot draw this game. This is our most important game. We're going to play this career mode. And we continue on here with Grassi giving the ball off to Bastoni. We're kind of controlling the play here. But Romagna gives it away to Diego Perotti. Perotti takes a shot. And they could have had the equalizer there. Roma very, very nearly got the equalizer as we have a throw in. Ruig. Birbiani makes a big, big cross, and Jadon Sancho continues his scoring form for us at the moment, getting a really important goal right before halftime. 45th minute, we go 2-0 up at home. Roma are shocked, the home fans are silenced, and Ruig from the throw-in gave it to Birbiani, and what a dipping cross it was. Jadon Sancho, not known for his headers, but he's gotten one there, put it past the goalkeeper. It's his 8th goal in Serie A. And what a way to get it. Jadon Sancho on form at the moment. He is killing it. We could have got a third there as we whipped the ball in. Unfortunately, it didn't come out to us. Pellegrini, ex-Roma player, gives it off to Grassi. Grassi takes a shot and unfortunately goes just past the Roma goal. And we continue on in this second half, trying to get the third, trying to wrap up this game as Roberto Inglese in his last game for us gets the shot away there, unfortunately. Couldn't get the third as we crossed the ball in. Roberto Inglese can't jump up high enough to win the header as Romagna tries to find the ball. He puts crosses the ball in. I can't even speak at the moment. And Birbiani, another player not known for his headers, gets a header. And we are 3-0 up at the Olimpico in Rome. The battle for Europa League football. We are absolutely dominating Roma at the moment. Somehow, some way, we have found 3 goals and Roma have not replied to any of them. We get another headed chance and we score it. But we have been known to let our lead slip sometimes with this Parma side. So we are not taking any chances today. Hopefully we are setting up shop, just sitting back, hopefully not conceding, and Glazer tried to get a fourth and tried to put this game beyond Roma's reach as we are through here again in the 80th minute. It's Roberto Inglese. I was trying to get him a goal in his last game for Parma as he's been one of our most important players this season, and he goes again, and Senjo makes another save, and he is going to go back to Napoli, I believe he is from, on loan from. And we're going to have to get a new striker, guys. So, like I said, put your transfer suggestions in the comments. But as I've been blabbing on, it's Luca Pellegrini, the Roma youth prospect that we bought from them in the past transfer window, in the starting transfer window, concedes a penalty there and gets a yellow card against his former team. And we have one last penalty. It's going to be a consolation for Roma. But let's see how it pans out. It's 3 minutes of added time. We're into the 94th at the moment. It's Perotti steps up to take it. And it's Sepe in his last game in Parma. His last game for Parma. He made 2 penalty saves this episode. And he's topped it off. The last moment of the season. It's a Sepe penalty save in his last game for Parma, helping us reach Europa League qualification for next season. Roma have no European football to look forward to next season. In our first season back to Serie A, it's Parma qualifying in 6th position, getting Europa League football next season. We're looking forward to some European away days for season number 2. Birbiani, Sancho and Tonali getting the 3 goals to let us qualify. And to top off a great season, we get some Europa League football to look forward to next season. And as you can see there, tournament prize money, 32.4 million, as we finished 6th in Serie A. We get a bit of prize money there. We're going to top it off with some end of season training as the end of season 1 comes to a close. We're going to show you guys squad reports, our goals, as you can see there, just scrolling through. You guys can pause and have a look to see everyone's stats. You guys pretty much know our main players. You guys know like Cicciretti, Inglese, Sepe, a lot of key players. As you can see, they've growth changed. Sandro Tonali going up by 10 to a 76. David grew by 9. Taith Chong grew by 8, which was amazing. Gomes didn't really play much, but grew by 4. Jadon Sancho came in January and grew by 4, which is great. Mertedja grew by 4. Shaparenko also did the same. Alessandro Pellizzari grew by 3, and he's going to have a big role next season in goals. As Bastoni as well, another player on loan that's not going to be with us. Romagna and Pardew making some decent growth. Our scout future star, Roche. Pellegrini as well, also grown by 3. Di Marco is a player on loan. Sprocati as well is another player on loan. Ciciretti, a player on loan. So a lot of players. Grassi as well. Just too many players are not going to be with us next season. We're going to have to spend big next season if we want to compete in Serie A and the Europa League. Roberto Inglese, one of our best players this season, is going back to Napoli on because he was on loan. Jonathan Biabiani didn't go down at all, just stayed at his normal overall. But yeah, these are our main performers this season. Sepe with 40 appearances, Grassi 35, Biabiani with 34, Inglese, Ciciretti, Romagna, all in the 30 appearances plus range. As you can go down and see, the players that didn't really play that much this season, some of them came in January as well. So that is the full look at the squad report. You guys can pause, have a look to see what in-depth stats, in detailed stats you want to see, as we have Ronaldo getting the golden boot, 29 goals, 10 goals more than Caputo in second, but Inglese, our top goal scorer, with 15 goals in 31 games. What a season from the loanee from Napoli. He's going to go back. So Sepe, Grassi, Ciciretti, Bastoni, all these players are on loan, and they're going to go back to their parent clubs for next season. We're not going to be able to use them in the Europa League, but our manager objectives, we've completed all of them. Youth development, tick. I mean, we signed a few youth players. We got 10.6 million earnings from shirt sales. I mean, we're ticking so many boxes across the board here. We avoided relegation. We reached a round of 32. Within 2 seasons, we finished mid-table. We did even better than that. We finished in Europa League position. So a 96 manager rating is fitting for us as we end off the season on a high. What a season it was. Europa League qualification. Here's the last view of the table. We end up with 18 wins, 11 draws, and 9 losses, which is pretty decent. We end up getting 65 points in Serie A, finishing in 6th. But we're going to have a look further down the table just to see what happened at the other end. We have Spal, Frosinone, and Empoli going back down to Serie B as Genoa, Cagliari, Chievo Verona, Bologna, and Udinese survive relegation, finishing in the bottom to lower part of the table as we move on. The Serie A, what a season it was. We survived relegation, which was probably the goal for Parma in real life and just in this career mode, and we finish in 6th with the big boys. It's Juve coming in first, getting the Scudetto, Inter, Lazio, AC Milan. Oh my gosh, what a season. We finish in the top 6. And we have so much to look forward to in season number 2 of the Parma Road to Glory career mode. We've got some Europa League away days to look forward to, some more Serie A action, and we got some more transfers to get to. Guys, comment your transfer suggestions down below, and we will address them in season number 2 next week. And we're going to start it and hopefully play some Europa League games in season number 2. Some more end of season training. But if you guys did enjoy this season number 1 of the Parma Road to Glory and this season finale, smack the like button, subscribe for Parma season number 2. Follow me on Twitter. The link is in the description. Thank you guys so much for all your support. I appreciate it so, so much. And I'll catch you guys in season number 2 of the Parma Road to Glory career mode.